Champion Class in Winnipeg, Canada, this weekend, as to experience veteran put it on the line for a crack at the 175 cân Anh title. Rafael Dos Anjos has only had to fight in the welterweight division but in a solid debut against Tarek Seferin and a first round submission over Neil Magny, he has positioned himself against Dos Anjos in a contender fight in a very short time. Magny is a tall, well-round fighter and Seferin is an excellent striker with good takedown defense. Top test for a former lightweight champion Tosi Uehestek up against the top 10 in the division above and Dos Anjos fast with flying color. Now it's time to step up one more and the next level is Rudy Robby Lawler, the former welterweight champion and one of the most respected and seasoned fighters in the sport. He show up in the Octagon 15 years ago as a top 20 year old roller with natural power and a lot of potential. At this step in his career he was still a raw talent but fighting out of the Dynamite Fighting System in Iowa he was improving fast. Alongside Gridley Matthews, Dan Power and Spencer Fisher, it was the perfect play for a young fighter to learn his trade. After amassing a USFC record of 43, taking him to 83 overall, his martial arts journey took him on a tour of the other big promotion around the world. That experience proved invaluable, and following appearances in Pride, Elite and Chief Force, the Ruthless One returned to his old stomping ground and resigned with the USFC. Almost 10 years in his last fight in the Octagon, Lawler made his presence known at USFC 157 in February 2013, knocking out Josh Koscheck in devastating fashion. By the end of 2013, he had 3 impressive victories and was set to face Johnny Hendricks in the new year. In what turned out to be fight of the year in March 2014, Lawler lost a half up fight round decision but was back in title contention by December and was successful in the title rematch. Lawler with McDonald will lie long in the memory getting in his first defense at USFC 189. He not only retained his own title but also his fight of the year title. This time it was against Rory McDonald in what was one of the most incredible fight I've ever watched. I actually have a photo from the fifth round on my home gym motor inspired me during my own training session. If you haven't seen it, I recommend that you check it out. Needless to say, Lawler is one of the few fighters that achieved legend status while still active. He lost the title last year to current champ Tyron Woodley, but got back in the win column with a top 3 round against Donald Cerrone at UFC 214 this summer. This fight is his opportunity to get back to the top of the division and a win here get him halfway there. If you like Rafael Dos Anjos bring some new challenges to Robby and I am intrigued as to how this fight will play out. Coming up from lightweight, Dos Anjos will be slightly undersized, giving up 3-4 inches in high end reach. What he lacks in stature though, he make up for in work rate and aggression. Typical of the Rafael Cordero style of Muay Thai, Dos Anjos command the center of the octagon with good hand combination and punishing low kick. Adding in clean work and takedown, he reminds his opponent that a ground or zone is also an option, making them more jumpy when he moves forward. Dos Anjos is the former lightweight champion of the world getting he is a skilled technician in oranges but will have to be cautious of that single punch knockout ability when closing in. Lawler learned early on what his game are and he built his whole game around them. Over a 15 year career he had honed those skills to the point where he was the best in the world in his weight class and he still feel like he can prove that status one more. For Dos Anjos it is about breaking a record and realizing a dream. win here give him the opportunity to be the first Brazilian to be champion and his name to a very exclusive pick in the history book. They both have about as much experience as each other and they will both need to draw on that to get the victory this weekend and move on to the title attempt. This cup is loaded with talent from the first fight to the main event. Kicking off the preliminary cut, we have the UK's own Danny Roberts taking on a very durable and strong Nordin Taleb. Then the main cut begin with Misha Cercunov and Glover Teixeira, both trying to gain ground in the busy light heavyweight top 10. The co-main between MS and Lamas will be a great scrap, but the firecracker on the night will be Santiago Ponzinib Bio again, Platinum, My Perry. Both are knockout artists with a lot of momentum behind them. I am fascinated to see who rises to the occasion and move on, and who is left to regroup. What USFC Final Lawler vs. Dos Anjos, live on BT Sport 3 from on Saturday, December 16 on cách the early prelim exclusively on USFC Fight Pass from 9 giờ tối review content.